I really wanted to first of all thank everybody who was involved with helping. Helping bring Cornell Tech to New York City, because among other things, I'm not quite as tall as Ben, but I guess I still need to look this up a little bit. So I really want to thank everybody, both in the community and our elected officials and the leadership here at Cornell Tech, that played a role in bringing Cornell Tech to New York City, because amongst other things, it allowed me to come home. You know, I grew up in New York, on this big island just east of us, Brooklyn, Queens, Long Island, I live in all those places. And so it really gave me an opportunity, after being stranded on the West Coast for 20 years, to come home and be back in New York, where I'm from. And so it was really, really wonderful to be able to do that. I also wanted to thank Juliet for giving me the opportunity to speak to you today, because usually you don't put faculty in front of the public like this, because you never know what we're going to say. And so it's a real risk she's taking, and an indication of the trust she has in me to give me this podium in front of all of you today. I want to tell you a little bit about the course I'm teaching here and why I'm teaching it. So, As Juliet mentioned, a lot of my prior work has been on projects like all over the world, international development. I've worked in India, I've worked in Africa, I've worked in Central America. And so in all of these places I would deploy projects, but I'd have no idea if they were working or not, and most importantly, if they succeeded or failed, there was no accountability. You know, no one could come up to me and say, hey man, you made this thing, it had this effect, that effect, it's not working at all, what's going on? And I really wanted to work on a project wherein if I did something that didn't work, you could just grab me on the street and say, Tap, what's going on here, man? You know, why isn't this working the way I wanted it to work? And you know what they say, you know, be careful what you wish for, because here I am now, and I guess I have to stand and be accountable for what I've done. So anyway, I'm gonna tell you a little bit about the course that I've been teaching this semester. It's called Remaking the City. And really that's like it's kind of a tagline to get students interested and attracted into the course. And really it's really focused on kind of a service learning approach to learning about technology and its role in urban context. And so the goals of the class are, these are the main goals of the class. One of the main goals of the class is to understand the unique technology challenges that are faced by small civic-minded organizations. You know, typically when we think about technology startups or high technology, it's focused on either affluent consumers or it's focused on large businesses. You know, not many technology products are really serving small organizations, especially civic organizations. And my discussions with Susan, with Ben, and with others, it's really become quite apparent that these kinds of government organizations, civic organizations, have unique and persistent technology challenges. They're not being well addressed by current approaches and business models of technology. I also wanted to use this as an opportunity to rethink the relationship between urban community services and technology. What role can technology play in improving service delivery in urban contexts like Roosevelt Island? And finally, I think this is really, in my perspective, one of the most important goals of the course, and especially one of the most important impacts of the course in this first semester, is to start building a community that connects students from Roosevelt Island with all of the great organizations and people that live here. You know? And I think that's really something I was very excited to do, because as a university, and as Diane knows, as Juliet knows, students are a real asset. You know, faculty, well, you know, we can debate how useful faculty really are, but you know, faculty are as useful really as their students are, and students are the real asset that makes something like Cornell Tech a valuable part of our community. And so, this has been the focus of our course. You know, in terms of the content that students are learning, they're focused on what's called participatory design methods. This is how we design technology, not for users, but with users. You know, using with users, meaning with organizations, with people, with beneficiaries, as a direct part of the design process, where they can have input into the kinds of technologies that are built, how they're built, what interfaces they will have, and so on. Also, to expose students to some ideas at the intersection of technology and urban planning, how technology can impact things like immigration, affordable housing, infrastructure, transportation, and finally, thinking about how Roosevelt Island can not only be the home of Cornell Tech, but also an innovation partner, and where we work with individuals and organizations on the island to envision new technologies, new services, and new ways of delivering them. So we've had a number of projects. Can you raise your hand if you're working with one of the student teams this semester? Judy, I know Judy's working with them. I know, is that all we have today? Well, all my friends are not here. Oh, Christine is here? Okay, great. Good to see you too. So we've got a number of projects that are working with organizations all across the island. You know, we're working with the Garden Club on making a green map, application that exposes people to all of the wonderful green spaces on the island, working with the Main Street Dance and Theater Alliance on revamping their website and their email infrastructure. We've got a number of projects with REAC that Susan mentioned around mapping, events, sports park. We're working on a couple of projects with the Senior Center, Carter Burden, around developing a web literacy course for seniors and also open to the community. We're also looking at how to improve ride sharing for seniors at the center to be able to access medical services. We've got a project that's been thinking about how we can improve food and retail opportunities on the island. I know that's something we care about a lot. The students definitely care about food on the island, and so they're very vested in this idea of how do we find how to get food on the island and also expose students to the wonderful food that already exists on the island. We've been working with Reva. Tad was very gracious to offer his space for our opening event that kicked off this course, and we've been working with Tad on revamping Reva's web presence. And also Judy, we've been working with Judy on thinking of a new logo and a banner for the Historical Society that represents all the new things that have happened on the island in the last few years. So we've had a really great time working with all of these partners, and I think one of the most important things that have happened are all the great relationships that have happened between students and all these wonderful organizations. And so these are some of our students that have been working with Julia and Anthony at the Garden Club. And you know, one of the first week of the class, I saw them taking a tour of the island together, laughing, walking down, and I was like, this is what a town-gown relationship should be like. You know, people, students, organizations, residents, really working together, talking together, and having a shared experience of the place that they are in. Here are some of our students working over at Carter Burden on designing the web literacy course. Another great opportunity we have is to have, you know, the island has so many very interesting residents, people active in civic realms, in governance, in business, and so it's been really a great place to have guest speakers come in and talk to the class about all of these issues around planning, around technology, around government. And so we've had Susan Howard came in, they led a wonderful session on REAC. We had Carl Weisbrod, who talked about his experiences in planning in various city contexts. We had Judy gave us a wonderful tour of Roosevelt Island. I think that was still the highlight of the course, taking students around and getting Judy's perspective on the island and the historical significance on the island. We had Ben come in just today and talking about all the challenges that he faces trying to make change in the government, in the city, from a technology perspective. We also had people from off the island, Andrew Winters from Cornell Tech, talking about the relationship between Cornell Tech and the island and how he envisioned it and how it's played out. As well as Ruth Basalt and Paul McConnell from Link NYC, who have installed all these amazing kiosks all over the city with Wi-Fi and with touch screens. And you know, one question that came up is, why don't we have any of these kiosks on Roosevelt Island? And so I think, you know, that's something we really need to follow up with them about. So this has really been a great experience. So here is Judy leading our tour. You know, again, really, really great to see students. And I think because of this tour, now I'm seeing regularly students north of the bridge, north of this church, students going to Gristiti, students eating on the island, students going even to the lighthouse. And that was one of the things we really wanted to see, is students not just getting stuck on the south side of the island, but really using the whole island and thinking about it as their home and their community. Here's Howard and Ellen, Howard and Susan, I should say, regaling the class with their stories of the relationship between the REAC president and the board and how they make decisions over there. And finally, this is Ben, just today, came in and told our class about how government is adopting new technological interventions. So this has really been a really, really fun experience for me, but especially for the students. You know, I've gotten a lot of very positive feedback from the students about the class, how they think it's provided them a new perspective on the island, a new perspective on design, a new perspective on the role of technology in civic context. And I can't thank our partner organizations and the community enough for providing this kind of partnership to us that gives this educational experience to the students. You know, I really think of me as a professor, I think of the island and the community of the island as being teaching partners as well in providing students the access to new ideas, new experiences, new contexts where they can learn. And also our partners seem pretty happy for the most part, although it's always hard to please your customers in some sense. And apparently, according to Ben, I've committed to a smartphone app, Government in Your Pocket. So I didn't know I'd committed to that, but that seems to be something that I'm on the hook for now. So this is, you know, I'm saying this in jest, but it, you know, that's one of the hard parts of teaching a class like this. Students are students, they come and go, but really I've been so, so impressed by the quality of the students we have, the commitment they've had to these community projects, the follow-through they've shown, that I've just been really, really impressed by all of that. And it just speaks to the quality of the institution and the quality of the students we're able to attract here. So here we have some final projects. We're going to be thinking about ideas that could really have an impact on the island within the 3 to 5 year time frame. We'll see what happens with that. And you know, stay tuned for more. I'm really hoping that this becomes a course we're able to offer regularly here at Cornell Tech on Roosevelt Island. To expand the partnerships we have on the island, we're looking for new partner organizations to partner with next year, and really to increase the diversity and the breadth of the kinds of communities we engage with here on the island. So I'm really hoping that this becomes a course we offer repeatedly and becomes a core part of our educational mission here on Roosevelt Island. And finally, you know, I can't leave without thanking Jane Swanson. Jane's been a big part of this class. She's the one that's helped me broker all the relationships with island organizations. She's been there for every meeting. She's been there for almost every class. And so she's really a big reason why this class didn't happen. So really thanks to Jane. Thanks for having me. Thanks for giving me the time.